Welcome to the All Things Event Planning with April podcast. If this is your first time listening, then thanks for coming. Each week, we'll be spilling all the secrets that other event planners and industry professionals don't want you to know. From negotiating for the perfect venue to knowing when to walk away from a project, we'll give you the expertise so that you can plan any event, regardless of your experience level. Now, let's get into this week's topic with your host, April.
Hello, 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 and welcome to this week's episode of All Things Event Planning with me, April. I am the host, April, and thank you so much for tuning in to my podcast. So last week, we discussed the three popular events that you'll be planning this summer. And so now I want to go into a more personal topic that's related to me. And for any event planner out there who is also struggling with this, I'm going to give you some tips on things that have helped me during this new transition period in my life. And that is, I am pregnant. So one of the things that being an event planner and being pregnant presents is a whole new set of challenges. And so what I'm going to do is talk about some of the strategies that I've had to use now that I'm with child to make sure that I'm still on top of my game, my company still thrives, and that being an event planner and being pregnant doesn't hinder anything from anything that I do. So we're going to jump right into this topic, because I'm sure a lot of people out there are struggling with the same work-life balance. So don't worry, girl. I have some tips just for you. So the first thing that you're going to want to do now that you are pregnant, depending on which trimester you're in, will really determine how much you'll need to do of this. But you're going to have to start delegating. Delegation is going to be key in being successful in your new transition period of being pregnant. Now, what does that mean? And what does that look like, transitioning delegation to a new level? So if you're a part of a team, then there's going to be some things that you're not going to be able to do anymore. The bigger you get in your pregnancy, that means that you're not going to be able to bend. You're not going to be able to do deep twists. You're not going to be able to stand on your feet for a long period of time. So people are going to have to help supplement you in those areas so that you're able to get the rest that you need and still be able to do the event. Now, if you're an owner like I am, then this is where your team really will come in and support you, because they know that as you get bigger in your pregnancy, you're not going to be able to do the same things that you did during this time frame. So if you're usually the person picking up flowers, picking up decorations, doing all the run of the round, you may want to give that to another person during this time. What you can do is like all of the stuff that requires just sitting down or not being on your feet for a long period of time. So maybe scoping the room from time to time, being at check-in, being at setup, assisting with breakdown, just telling people what they need to do and what they don't need to do, things like that. You're going to have to really become a little bit more hands-off the further along in your pregnancy that you get. Now, even in your first trimester, depending on if you have morning sickness or not, some women suffer from this, some women don't. If you have morning sickness, then you're definitely going to have to find a way for people to handle some of the administrative things that you would normally do. So that can mean like someone taking early morning calls for you, or if your morning sickness comes towards the evening, then you work during the day, adjusting your schedule. Because again, being an event planner, you are in a very demanding field. It's very physical, and sometimes it can be emotional. So you want to be able to have people on your team who are going to allow you to take the breaks that you need to take so that you can still be on your A game, but also not affect your pregnancy at the same time. The next thing that you're going to have to do is find ways of de-stressing. Okay. So when you first find out you're pregnant, especially if this is your first baby, you're in shock. Okay. And you're like, oh my God, I don't know how to be pregnant. I don't know how being pregnant is going to affect my job, affect my work. I've heard of all these crazy things like pregnancy brain, and you can't do this and you can't eat that and you can't sit here and blah, blah, blah. So you're going through this transition of, okay, well, now you're freaking out because you're trying to do your job, but you also don't want to affect your baby. So you're going to have to find new ways of de-stressing so that you don't feel like, you are failing at being this new parent and failing at being this great employee. So like I mentioned, as everyone knows, I own my own event planning company, and there are some things that we've had to implement now that I am pregnant. And it's good to get the team involved too, because then they feel more a part of your pregnancy. They feel more a part of the process. They feel more like they are supporting you, which is what people really want to do during your pregnancy. I would say, honestly, people are really nice to you when you're getting married and when you're pregnant, because they know the amount of stress that especially the woman is under. And it's not just stress from like outside pressure. It's the stress from growing a human. So I would just take this time to just acknowledge that, you know, you are going through some changes. Your team is really trying to support you, and you should really allow them to support you in this capacity so that you can do what you need to do. So some of the ways of doing that is having massages. Now, most of the time, if you are, I would say, up to 6 or 7 months pregnant, you can get a good prenatal massage. After like 6 months, 7 months maybe, they really don't recommend doing prenatal massages because of the positioning of where they have to lay you, or you can't lay on your back. All the can'ts. But if you're able to get your team a massage and you all can participate in massage as a group, I think that's a really awesome activity. Like I said, it allows them to relax from having to kind of pick up the slack from where you just physically cannot do the current demands right now. And who doesn't like a massage? Right? Beach day. Now, I don't know about y'all, but where I am, it is hella hot and the humidity is freaking high. And some days you just can't go to the beach because it's too hot. And pregnant women, it is dangerous, sis. It is dangerous to be outside with high humidity and just heat for long periods of time. So if you're able to pick a cool day where you live in an environment where the humidity is not high, I'm in New York City, so we get really humid summers, but there are parts of the US and other countries that don't get as humid as the US or the Northeast. So just keep that in mind too when you're going to plan a beach day. Just go on a day that the humidity is not going to be so high, so that you and your team can really enjoy being on the beach. Who doesn't like the ocean? Who doesn't like the beach or the boardwalk? So that's another great way of de-stressing for you and your team. Mini golf is also another great group activity. It's a great way to see everyone's competitive side. It's something safe that you can do. And it's kind of funny to see, you know, you trying to swing the golf ball, you can't really see your feet at this point. So that's another awesome way of de-stressing for yourself and the team, or just walking in the park. Now keep in mind, like if you live in a dense city like I do in New York, where a lot of walking can be, depending on what part of your pregnancy you're in, sometimes you can walk that baby out the womb. But walking is also another great exercise. Like you and the team can go to the park and walk around a trail really quick. It's another way of just getting away from the office, getting away from doing the demands of event planning. And I find that as a group, we all really enjoy that. It gives you another way of connecting. It gives you another way of talking to each other. And people love that. They just love it. You also have to be able to start taking care of yourself. When you're pregnant, you have to become a little bit more selfish in your primary and personal care. I know sometimes, especially when you're the owner of an organization, a lot of the responsibility falls on you. So you're still going to be able to make the top level executive decisions, but you're really going to have to take care of yourself and know that, you know, you got to know your limit. You know, you got to know your limit. You have to be able to communicate to your team what you really need done, what you can't do. And you also have to just drink a lot more water. It's really a challenge, especially if you're not a huge water drinker, to increase the amount of water that you need to take. But I found that by drinking a lot more water and eliminating a lot of the soda or juices, or even some of the smoothies that have a lot of sugar in them, because you're not as dehydrated. Being pregnant, you get dehydrated really quickly, especially if you live in climates where it's really, really humid and the air just sucks all of the moisture out of your soul. So being able to drink a lot more water, knowing your limit, talking to people will really help in taking care of yourself. Also, if you need to take a day, take a day. Some people say that in their second trimester, the first trimester, they're really, really tired and fatigued because they suffer from morning sickness. And then the second trimester, they get their energy back. some people like myself, we find that the first trimester, everything was fine. You didn't have any morning sickness or any of those issues, but now you're a lot more tired in your second trimester. So you have to kind of know like, okay, well, my body is transitioning into I'm a lot more fatigued. So I know that I'm gonna have to increase the things that I limit so that I'm able to take care of myself and still be an effective leader to my team and also prepare for baby. And you should never feel guilty about being able to take care of yourself, because again, being pregnant and having such a demanding, stressful job is very, very stressful. A lot of women actually sometimes have to go out on early short-term disability or maternity leave early because of the stress of having a demanding job and also trying to take care of themselves. So just keep that in mind that you want to try, if you can, to continue to work as long as you can, depending on, you know, your maternity leave policy at your organization. Just try and push through as much as you can so that you can bring in a happy, healthy baby and also be a happy, healthy event planner. Because at the end of the day, when you are the owner of your team really, really needs you, and you still want to be able to create that awesome work-life balance for you and the baby and your team. And you shouldn't let being pregnant determine or dictate how you are as an event planner, because you're always going to be an awesome event planner. You're just temporarily, you know, growing a human. So yeah, as I'm starting to go through this process myself, I just always tell people, you know, you have to look at the bigger picture and just know that you're doing multiple work for multiple people and that it's going to be okay. It's just temporary. And after that, you'll be able to drop down and get your eagle on. So that's it for this week's episode. The event planner is pregnant. Now what? So I want to thank you so much for tuning in. Make sure you are sharing, liking, and subscribing to our podcast so that you never miss a new episode of us. I also have a blog post topic that is related to this episode. I will make sure to provide the link in the description of this episode. If you want to check it out, it is aprileventdiaries.com/theeventplanner. Now what? And thank you so much again for tuning in, and we will check you out on the next episode. Take care. Bye.
You've been listening to the All Things Event Planning Podcast.
All Things Event Planning Podcast.
With your host, April. Loved this week's episode? Subscribe to our podcast on iTunes, SoundCloud, Stitcher, or Google Play. It's very much appreciated. Thank you.